any other questions for Oleg before we go into our exciting form management panel? All right, cool. So we're going to call up Xavier Lecauchois, and we have to my right Jarid Cottrell from Booz and Hamilton. We're going to talk about just a few minutes about what cloud management is actually. While they're working that out, I just wanted to go through a couple things. Introducing the topic of why we, what cloud management is, and why we decided to open source ManageIQ. Because when you think about, you know, who wants to be managed, right? Who needs management? You know, when you think about it, when I hear the word cloud management, I think we're rapidly approaching the point where we can just start dropping the word cloud and just talking about infrastructure and IT management. Because that's really what it's about. It's about shipping. It's about your virtualized environment. It's about your public cloud instances, your OpenStack instances. It's about whatever other environmental stations you want to play around. It's really the whole thing. And it, when you look at ManageIQ and CloudForms, it's really designed to be about the entire infrastructure. But the thing about cloud management in particular is when you look at the trajectory of various technologies over the years, you can see kind of a pattern. New technology introduced, you know, Gartner has our hype cycle. I'm just going to draw the circle of arrows. Gartner has our hype cycle. But when you look at new technologies come in, everyone's enthusiastic about it. They want to deploy it everywhere. You can look at Docker and containers right now, and everyone's deploying them wherever they can. And then they realize, oh, right, there's no way to manage, you know, thousands of them in deployment. There's no way to really pull them in with all the rest of the infrastructure that you have to manage. So there's things get adopted, and then people say, oh, oops, hold back here. Let's figure out how we can actually integrate this in with the rest of our workflows and the rest of our environments. And that's where something like ManageIQ comes in. You'll notice that on the agenda, I think there is a talk about container management or how we want to integrate that in the future. With Docker, is there? Okay. So if anyone has some data for that research, technology hype cycle, you can see that there's a need for a strong management piece to sort of bring it all together. So that's great, but what about the open source part? Why did we open source ManageIQ? And put it simply, when you think of the rapid movement of technology that I had in the previous slide, you need a management platform that can actually keep up with it, is extensible, is customizable, is something that you can change when you need, on the fly, to future-proof your environment. When you look at open source versus proprietary models, you know, proprietary models are all sort of one-way flow of information. I mean, I know there is some, you know, customer feedback that gets integrated with that stuff, but in reality, it's the vendor making stuff and pushing it back to the customer. The revolution of open source was about the customer being on an equal playing field with the developers. And I'm kind of, in this graphic, that's kind of what I'm trying to demonstrate. And when you have that customer equal footing, the feedback process just happens so much more efficiently. And that's what we're trying to capture here. That's why we have this design summit. That's why we open source ManageIQ. That's what we're trying to build more energy around. Because when we think about open source innovation, it's all about a managed ecosystem, bringing people together. And I'm going to skip ahead to the part that I really want to talk about. Because when we think about what we're trying to do here, it's about creating the network effect with everyone together to produce experience some of its parts. We start up as a small startup. Actually, they did. I wasn't part of it. But they start up as a small startup. It was part of Red Hat. Each step along the way, more resources were added. And so we get to this community effort where we have even more resources added. And so we get, and it's really about engaging with communities to fill the gaps and make ManageIQ, you know, the world's default open source management platform. That's really what it's all about. So, I want to introduce Xavier Lecauchois, who is the product manager extraordinaire for CloudForms and ManageIQ, and Jarid Cottrell. So why don't we start off with Xavier, why don't you kick it off with a couple minutes, and then Jarid, you can kick it off with a couple minutes, and then we'll have a little Q&A.
Yeah, can you hear me? Yeah. So, well, first of all, welcome. It's amazing to see how many people are here, and what I find really amazing is the fact that we have both engineering partners and customers in one is that going to affect and it didn't really understand the model. So for the first 12 months, we really started researching and understanding how open source works and what does, and on how can we open source the ManageIQ technology. And it became very, very clear after a while to understand that the only way we wanted to do it big, and we wanted to do it in a way that it's not just an engineering set of code that is being uploaded upstream, but we wanted to make sure that both the users, the partners, were able to be together and work together with the engineering. And I think that's what is leading us today. And there's been a huge effort leading when we decided, so when we decided to say, let's be serious and let's go to the open source side. Remember, we decided that over the Christmas break of 2013, I think. And we said, okay, well, when we start the new year, we're going to keep you full steam and start going. And what does it mean? It's not only engineering and a huge effort to do in order to render the code legal so that it can be put on stream, what kind of license we were going to be using, and all these kind of things. But we also wanted to create everything that goes around the top of ManageIQ and so forth, and all that model that was implemented. And that's when John Mark started to join the team and bring his expertise into it, to be able to, with a couple of other OSS members from right up, to be able to say, let's do it together. And I think what we've done is, if you look at the activity that is going on right now in the open source, it's fantastic. I mean, our engineers are doing a fantastic job at communicating and making things very, very transparent and straight. And so, same thing, they have to work a lot on themselves to be able to do that. You guys are contributing. I mean, I've seen people left and right, customers contributing the effort about, hey, here's what we're doing, and here's how we are doing it. Please provide feedback, working with us. And we have people like Booz and we have expanded the technology in a way that is actually remarkable that you guys are going to learn about today. And that's what we want. So for us, the cloud management platform is really, I would say, a set of, it's more than just technology. It's a way to get everybody together around management, very innovative, and allow partners and users to contribute to that. So in the code, there is some specific sessions going on. In the other way, that I'm going to talk about modularizing so that partners can integrate with providers at a much, much faster pace, that it doesn't require as much expertise and knowledge in order to be able to do that. We are doing some work upstream that John Mark will hopefully talk about how people can start exchanging content in a much more peaceful way and facilitate that for you. And then we're going to also talk about the future, how do we make it, how do we expand above and beyond the current set of capabilities that we have, so talking about, and I know it's not part of it, but we're going to talk about configuration management, like how we integrate things like, make it easier to integrate things like, chat puppet and the configuration management providers, right? So start steering into different areas, talking about, I know you had on the previous slide, the financial management aspect of things, where we have a set of basic capabilities that partners can integrate further and provide, their first-hand expertise, let's say, around chargeback, by being able to integrate those two systems together. So, and with that being said, that's kind of my, my pitch to say, I'm very, very happy to see everybody being here. It's fantastic, and I'm looking forward to 2 days of, really collaborating and contributing and deciding what's on the roadmap we're going to do now, not only over the next 3 to 6 months, but, in the long term, start putting it in the ground. This is where we are going as a group.
Great, thanks. So, I want to talk about fire. Screaming children and jellyfish. Let's start with fire. So, I Googled cloud management to see if there's a clever definition of my cloud management. Just created like a hit. It was Wikipedia. It said cloud management is the management of cloud resources. Okay. No, but I think, if we look at where IT is going, where cloud is going, I think the day for just single data centers. Disparate type data center systems is really common. Most of our clients, Booz Allen is very customer focused for a large integrator or consulting firm. And what we're seeing is really a trend towards multiple environments, hybrid, public cloud. And to do that, you really need a management platform. That's really what I think ManageIQ is. It's really an enabler to address a lot of those use cases. I think it's also preparing us for just
talk about some of this in more detail about doing. So that's our code name, that's our project name. So we'll learn a lot about that from there. First class to the next part of the world here. In the next couple of days, I'm going to get to talk to them. We'll talk about a couple of things over what Booz Allen is doing and got us here today. What we've built, what we're going to need to source. And then tomorrow, we'll talk about what our plans are going for with the community and just have to go over the plans.
Thank you. Thank you, Jarid. So I think we have about 5 or 10 minutes. So what we can do here is just have a little discussion up here. If you guys have questions, just raise your hand and I'll call on you and we'll keep going through that for the next 5 or 10 minutes. Jarid, you mentioned on our podcast discussion that you were saying that customers really are starting to ask for and demand the open source part. Can you talk a little bit to that and how it appeared into your involvement with ManageIQ?
Yeah, so it's definitely a trend. I mentioned about cloud. I think it's they want a solution. They want a solution that can respond to their requirements. And it really brings us to the source. There's three options. Our guys are using proprietary. There's a lot of engineers as well. Our startups that have been on course. And then the four options are open source. This is it. We got a pretty good response. And what we're also seeing.
Did you ever think that ManageIQ, the bits for that would be open source, but when you guys were?
Yeah, as I said, in my experience, it's been for 20 years with a private company, and we keep things very close to our chest, right? I mean, that's IP, that's patent, and that's, you know, that's the differentiation. So I do not think that this would be, now I can tell you that when we created ManageIQ, we know, like mentioned, we created ManageIQ based on the open source stack, right? And because we understood that that was the way for us to quickly and very quickly iterate and be able to gain the benefit of the open source. So when it was time for us to consider going open source, and we looked at those models and how it benefited us, it is to create this product, right? So I think that's what we're learning is that, you know, to your point, I mean, open source first one needs to come to mind. We came to that point, we learned it, and it creates a model that I think is working really, really well.
Stack instance, but of our instances, but it's not only OpenStack, and that's the thing, is that the difference of this community is about hybrid clouds, in the sense of not only focusing on the the open source cloud like OpenStack, but VMware support, you just integrated into news like CDM and planning for Azure and all that. So it's really about the management of hybrid cloud, and that's how we want to build it. The architecture that is going to be proprietary vendors to come and be able to integrate their technology. So it's not about taking over from what they're doing. It's about letting them integrate with the ManageIQ community. So I think that's a great foundation for what we're doing.
Thank you for bringing up OpenStack, because when we think about it, why should anyone have to deploy this stuff internally? Why can't we just fulfill the dream of the public cloud? What's stopping us from going all public all the time as opposed to you?
Well, I think there's a lot of regulation. I mean, I think there is one place to answer that question. But, I mean, it's like, there's a set of proprietary. I mean, I know that Christian is going to talk about, European, limitations in terms of what can be done, where data protection and all these kind of things. So I think the dream of, more public is
so a lot of times it's, you know, talking to the CIO, it's like, okay, I already have this feature in place, we'll put this in this here. However, we don't want to continue the life of it. Let's let it, you know, die in the next 3 to 5 years. And slowly start to transition to hybrid cloud. That's really the big thing right now, and you have to have a platform to do that. I think the other thing is really about governance and security. So, speaking of, you know, you mentioned hardcore developers and admins, what do you think the story is around ManageIQ with respect to, you know, the movement of DevOps, the idea that, you know, operations must also be, you know, part of the engineering process and vice versa? How do you feel that plays into it, and how do you feel this goes on?
It just has to do with, two big things that we're looking at, and I think it's part of the platform, just APIs. Plus having consistency, which, you know, I know a lot of developers just can't do really what they want, but there doesn't need to be a little bit of control. And having this platform allows them to go do what they want, be self-service, but allows enterprise to still just really focus on saying, you know, liability and the governance. And that just where the data is, so data is really important. And we're saying the environment, having a place that,
it's a really good point because, yeah, as we recently witnessed with Hardcore Lead and then with Shellshock, you know, when you have to manage all of these things together, it makes it really difficult to pinpoint where your vulnerabilities are. You want to talk a bit about, you know, how security plays a role in this?
Yeah, so, I mean, again, we talked about control. I mean, I can give you an example. We heard about the Shellshock recently and the fact that, you know, it's so spread, right? I mean, it's spreading all over the world. So,
know, zero-day exploits are kind of a pitch under the gun when it's time to turn things
over. For you, every time there's a deep on the scene, I mean, it's like there's a video, how do you use ManageIQ to deal with this exploit? So we're going to make it measure, and we're going to get it out, and then to make it so that even in an easier way, we're going to make it so that you can automatically download it and stream it into your own way.
Just another aspect of security that I hope starts to talk about is just hardening the platform itself, groups maintaining best practices. So I don't know if I am one of those things. I think there's an opportunity to develop platforms as well.
Yeah, I know you guys have a lot of government clients. They don't care about security, right? Not important at all. Do we have any questions from the audience? You can't be two places at once. Sure. So, just so you know, we're having both tracks recorded, and I'll pass those as soon as possible, so if you miss one that you wanted to see, you'll be able to see it later. But the difference is, in this track, and you guys should see the agenda under their printouts, so you'll see it around. The difference is, this track is for extending the platform as it exists today. Basically, how to be a power user, or if you're a developer, how to use it as a platform for your applications that you The other track, it's Winston Ballroom TE, is about they're going to be planning the next session. So there's going to be four developers planning out the features for the next release and the longer term roadmap. So that's the difference. This is more geared for users. That one's more geared for four developers. So and the split here is probably going to be about half of them as far as the people in each. Does that answer your question? Okay. Without further ado, without any other questions, I think we're going to split up into the breakouts.
Just one note on the engineering track, and I don't want to scare people that it's for developers only, right? It's about, you know, the design, understanding, representing what are the requirements that you're chasing and how those integrations should be done. So there's, if you look at the track, I mean, there are things that are maybe a little more in-depth in terms of you know, speeding the engine and how it's built today, but there are also things like integration with, you know, the form, which is about, you know,
thank you, Zob. Thank you, Jarid. Give these guys a hand.